Welcome to this tutorial on how to run Maestro Schrödinger Maestro jobs remotely on CSC Puhti supercomputing platform. Let's first quickly check on CSC's Maestro page how this happens. What are the actual steps? The first four steps you need to do once: log into Puhti, load the module. And if this is the first time, you need to create this Schrödinger hosts file and then copy the hosts from this host file to your local installation. Then for the actual simulations, you set up the simulation on your local computer using the graphical user interface. Instead of running the files, you write them to disk, copy the files to Puhti, probably edit the submission script a little bit, perhaps you don't need to, then run the script which sends the job to the queuing system, and once the job has been done, copy the results back to your local computer. Okay, now let's go through these steps one at a time. I'm using Windows, and on Windows you can use the Windows PowerShell to do these things, and to log in to Puhti. It's as simple as this. I've set up the SSH keys, so I type once the passphrase and then I don't need to do it again. So here I will do module load Maestro, and I also specify the version. Now it's set up, and then I can, yes, well, let's go back. This error didn't appear, so it's fine. And now I would need to copy the host descriptions from this Schrödinger hosts file to my local computer Schrödinger.hosts file. And the idea here is that when these hosts are available, when I write the script to the disk or define what kind of resources my calculation will use, the hosts that are available on Puhti are available also on your local computer, so the graphical user interface will set everything up and you only need to copy over the files. So let's see what they look like. So this is the file, and everything below here please copy to your local host file. There's a lot of different hosts, and these are actually the ones that define what kind of resources each of them use. Since this is on your in your home directory, you can edit this file if you want, but only do that if the queues don't match the needs of your calculation. So next, let's see where this Schrödinger host file is on your local computer. So the Schrödinger hosts file in the local computer you will find in the Schrödinger installation folder. This is on the Windows machine, and on Linux and Mac you can find it with the dollar Schrödinger environment variable. So here you have the same file as was in Puhti, and I've copied the lines here so that these hosts called interactive and test and normal 72 hours and so on will be available locally. Very good. So these were the preparatory steps, and now we can move on to running Schrödinger. In this example we will run Desmond, and for example you can look for a tutorial from here on how to do that. So I'll do this a little bit more quickly. I'll use the protein preparation wizard to download one protein and prepare that for simulation. Then set up the system with the default parameters, and also this I'll do locally. And finally set the molecular dynamics parameters. And here we'll just make a very short simulation since we want to demonstrate how to run this stuff. And now instead of running it, I will select here job settings and select the GPU test partition because this is a quick run. And instead of running the job, we will write the input files to disk. And now we got this a little bit long name, and this is the location where we can find it. Now let's go to the command line and navigate to that folder and copy the whole folder. R means recursive, and it was called Desmond MD job underscore 2 to Puhti. Now I will actually copy directly to the scratch directory. And this scratch directory you can actually see here. No, you can't see it here, but you can see it on your Puhti scratch folder. So this is set up when you run the script for the first time in Puhti. So this command will copy the files to Puhti in this folder, and underscore one, of course, it's now preparing to create the next one. So this is copying over the contents of the whole folder, and now in Puhti we should go to the same place. And here we see that the folder is appearing. And here the beautiful thing is that we have this script that actually has everything needed to submit and run the simulation. We're specifying the GPU test folder, one job at a time, and the other specifications. We have already Maestro loaded, so the only thing we need to do to submit it is to run the script. Typically in CSC you have to create batch script files to run simulations on the compute nodes through the queuing system, but Maestro is a special case. It has its own interface to the queuing system, and instead of creating your own batch job files, you put the parameters in this command and it will do it. The intention is not to run anything on the login nodes, but this will not result in the simulation running in the login node, but in the host, which is a Schrödinger speak or Schrödinger term for this queue definition and parameters. And when you look for the Schrödinger.hosts file, you can see what kind of queue parameters this GPU test actually refers to. And here is another thing. When you run this job, you get a warning that there is a user-specific host file located in your home directory. And this is intended. This is the most useful way for us to figure out how to support multi-user environment in Puhti. So this warning you can safely ignore. If you get any other warnings or errors, then please consider them. Okay, so now the job is running. We can check what jobs the Schrödinger job control sees. And also this shows that this is the Slurm job ID. And we can also see that it's running in the GPU test partition, and it's been spending 22 seconds. So now it will take a moment for the job to finish. but once it finishes, then we can download the results back. Okay, now the simulation is done, so I don't have a job running anymore. With slurm accounting, I can check what was the last few jobs that have done. With this command, we can check how well the job used resources. And the CPU efficiency was there and there. And the GPU efficiency is actually quite low. Normally, Desmond uses the GPU very well, but in this case, the actual MD simulation was short, and most of the time was spent preparing the system for that. So this is not actually indicative of the real performance. But if you see a low figure like this for long simulations, then reconsider whether it makes sense to use GPUs. Okay, so let's go back to the local folder. And now we'll copy the Desmond job MD job 1 to the local folder. And now we get all the results from the remote server. And we can then import the results here. Great.